Hey everyone! Before we get into this video, I just want to say a big announcement. The second YouTube channel that I promoted months and months ago, and I asked you guys to subscribe to it, January 1st, 2019, that's when the first video is going to be released. Still not going to give you any context as to what it is, so go over to subscribe if you want to see what's happening. Nothing lucid dreaming though. It's not lucid dreaming related, I must say that. So if you're looking for lucid dreaming stuff, then cut your losses, it's not going to happen. Anyway, on with the video. As some of you may or may not know, I actually have a degree in sport exercise science, meaning that I know more about exercise than I do about lucid dreaming. So when I tell you why lucid dreaming is aided by exercise, you have to understand that I kind of know what I'm talking about. I'm not one of these people who just make a video about exercise is good and here's why with no actual proof behind it. So I can tell you safely, I know my stuff. But before we get into the video as to how and why exercise can help you with lucid dreaming, I have to make a disclaimer because it's inevitable that I need to. If you're thinking about drastically changing your exercise habits, it must be noted that I am not a doctor, and more specifically, I am not your doctor. So please consult your physician before you take on extra exercise routines, especially if you're overweight. As most cases with overweight people, exercise can lead to injury because exercise does not help you lose weight. It is your eating habits that helps you lose weight. So if you're looking to change your weight, then look at your diet rather than your exercise habits. Diet is about weight, exercise is about your body, not weight. There's some fancy videos that explain that a bit better than I did. Anyway, on with the video. One of the most important things that you all should be focusing on if you're trying to lucid dream is the amount of sleep that you get each and every single night. However, as mentioned in a previous video that I've made called Casey Neistat's Theory of Sleep versus Exercise, it's not only about the amount of sleep that you get, but it's also about the quality, how good that sleep is. If you sleep for 9 hours, but during the night you find yourself waking up and tossing and turning, wait, all the time, and it doesn't matter how much you sleep, if you're not getting a good quality of sleep, then it doesn't count for anything. Exercise can help you with this. Exercise can help you with a multitude of different conditions, varying from physical ailments to social ailments to mental health conditions, as long as you do the right type of exercise at the right intensity, and that's very important. The reason that it helps with physical and mental conditions is because of two reasons. First of all, when you exercise, you get a rush of hormones through your body. And the second reason is that it helps you sleep better. And because you sleep better, then your overall health will improve because of the functions of good sleep. And as you've probably experienced yourself, when you exercise during the day, that night you fall asleep easier. It's almost as if your body kind of knows that it needs to sleep. The reason your body kind of knows that it needs to sleep is because as you are exercising during the day, you are putting an amount of stress on your body. And this stress can be healed through the process of sleep. Things like micro tears in your muscles get repaired, things like fractures, tiny fractures in your bones get repaired due to impact, things like this. However, if you lead a non-exciting life like I do, a very sedentary lifestyle, then the amount of stress that you put on your body due to this lifestyle choice is very low. And therefore, the requirement for your sleep is also very low too. If you apply more stress to your body, then that means your body needs more sleep to repair the stress. Also, exercise helps reduce two different mental states, anxiety and stress. I'm not talking about stress on your body, I'm talking about mental stress, which is bad. Pretty much all of my clients that I've had in lucid dreaming have all stated that those two factors, stress and anxiety, are the main reasons that you do not sleep effectively. So by getting some exercise in, your body's anxiety levels and stress levels are reduced, helping you sleep easier. If you combine that with a very tired body because of exercise, then you get a very sleepy person and therefore you sleep easier. So what does this have to do with lucid dreaming specifically? As I said at the start of this video, you should be focusing on the amount of sleep that you get, but not just the amount of sleep, but your sleeping patterns and sleeping behaviors. I went into a lot of detail in a previous video about sleep and the functions of sleep, so click on that video to know a little bit more about what I'm talking about. I also went into detail on the Patreon page as part of a podcast. So if you're one of the Patreon supporters at the specific tier, then look at the podcast, or rather listen to the podcast. However, the Cliff Notes is sleep is vital, and the more sleep that you have, the greater your chances of becoming lucid is. Exercise helps facilitate your ability to fall asleep and remain asleep during the night. It also helps improve your cognitive functions. So if you have an improved cognitive function, it means that you can think more clearly during the day, which also helps with lucid dreaming. It gives you that extra edge on becoming lucid that somebody else might not have. Ergo, exercise helps with lucidity. There are other things that do have an impact on your lucid dreaming that is a byproduct of having an exercise routine, and that is by the very definition of exercise routine. It's a routine. If you have a routine lifestyle and you have more discipline in lifestyle routines, then that will give you the extra edge on becoming lucid, because it gives you time to dedicate towards dream journaling. It gives you time to dedicate in your routine towards having a morning routine, an evening routine. It dedicates your time to these different factors that you might not have if you are less disciplined in your day-to-day life. Routines can also help with lucidity, is what I'm trying to say. So what exercises should you do? Well, if you're watching this video and you don't exercise, then I implore you to not just take up running. You need a low impact form of exercise so that your body can get used to having exercise as part of a routine. If you have high impact exercise and you just go straight into it, then it can actually damage your ankles, damage your knees, damage your hips. Especially if you go running on the roads, you're constantly just hitting the ground with your feet, then that travels up to your knees, and you're just over and over again having these tiny things that impact your joints. If you can join a sports club, that's probably best, because you want to make exercise fun, and running continuously isn't fun, swimming continuously isn't fun. So if you want to actually get into exercise, then get into a sport, make exercise fun so that it seems less like a chore and more like something that you want to do. I just want to chime in here to say that I did originally go into huge detail of how to run or how to swim, but it made the video very, very long. So what I've done is I've made that an exclusive bit of content for the Patreon supporters, of anyone on $4 or more. So if you're a Patreon supporter and you want to know specifically the exercise programs to do, then head over to patreon.com/GizEdwards and see the very detailed program. Thank you. That's pretty much it. If you exercise consistently and you manage to up your workload of exercise to every day, then it will help you sleep 100%. It may be a little bit of a struggle to wake up in the morning, but then you just need to jig the amount of time that you sleep for, and one day you'll find the perfect balance and you'll be like, why didn't I do this before? Exercise is wonderful. You should all do it. And that's pretty much it for this video. There are a few announcements I want to make before you disappear. The first announcement I want to make is that last month's Patreon was the most successful I've ever had, and I want to say a big thank you to all of you who donated, because I was moving house at the time and I kind of ran out of money. I spent a lot of money on things that I thought I needed, which I did need, but moving house is always more expensive than you think. So I moved into this new place, this new office and things, and I just want to say a big thank you, because if I didn't have that extra little bonus from the Patreon page, then I would be in a little bit of a pickle right now. So again, thank you very much. The second thing I want to say is that I just want to give an announcement to the second channel. Once again, The World of Giz, go over, subscribe to it. It might be called G-Files at the moment, but trust me, go and subscribe. 1st of January will be the first video and all will be revealed. So until next time I create a video on this channel, bye.